2016, Norton became the fastest British bike ever to lap the TT circuit. This year, the team is poised to take another step forward.
So much an island as a battleground.
Now mind those bikes, they're the new Nortons.
Not so much racing as a reckoning.
The world's greatest road race and the world's greatest riders.
A legacy like no other. Isle of Man TT. Will we see the ordinary do the extraordinary? Like Stanley Woods, a toffee salesman who became the sport's first superstar. Or will we see a genius like Jeff Duke rewrite the rule book?
Another record. He's been going like the wind.
Maybe we'll see a superhuman effort.
On the left, Giacomo Agostini, and beside him, Mike Hillwood. It's victory again for Mike Hillwood.
Or will we see the epic fight that's too close to call? Hizzy and Foggy remorselessly driving each other to new heights.
And it's history! A win for his love and a win for Norton!
It's the most exciting motorsport battleground in the world. Always has been. Always will be.
It's just a really evocative name and evocative brand, and I think there's a little bit of the underdog and the Dunkirk spirit about what we do here, taking on the might of the Japanese and BMW, and that's what it's all about. It's just a real British thing.
We decided early on that we needed to go back to the TT. You know, we won the first one in 1907, and we wanted some pedigree and to be building some information about modern sports bikes. And the best place for us to go and do that was the TT.
The results are there. We came from 18th to 7th with the same motor, so we had the same power. We developed the electronics package. We were able to engineer frame stiffness and characteristics into the bike, and we produced the fastest British bike ever around the Isle of Man.
It's a very, very pure development process that we've done at the TT and road racing. We're doing 80, 90, 100 mile an hour sweeping right left turns, going over the bumps, and then getting the power on at 100, 120 mile an hour, etc. So when we say we're race developed, we're road race developed.
So, tell me, Paul, what happened at the 2016 TT that was so special for Norton?
Well, Maria, it was during the practice sessions that year that the Norton factory team, like most teams, were having a few issues with their bikes, which is the main reason for the practice sessions, to iron out any faults before the race. David Johnson, nicknamed Davo, who started his TT racing career in 2010 riding for Honda, was riding for Norton this year alongside his fellow countryman, Cameron Donald. However, Davo's bike was suddenly cutting out at the same part of the mountain circuit on every lap. The team simply couldn't figure it out. It appeared that the kill switch may be the problem, but it seemed to be functioning perfectly well, so there was some confusion amongst the team. Then someone suggested mounting a GoPro camera on the bike to see if anything strange was happening. So one was fitted and Davo went out again, and yes, the same thing happened, but this time they had some video footage to examine. The video revealed the cause of the problem. It was the fairing. It was flexing so much at that part of the circuit that it was hitting the kill switch and causing the engine to cut out. So, the fairing was trimmed away in that area, and Davo went out again, and he put in the fastest lap so far during the test session. The bike was riding like a dream. As I am sure you can imagine, the team were now euphoric and had high hopes for a great TT. It was during this euphoria that Charles Reynolds, owner of Kickstart Motorcycles, a Norton dealership and a personal friend of Devo, decided that he wanted to do something special to mark this stupendous occasion.
So, was that when Charles decided that he was going to build a special Norton as a tribute to this event?
Oh yes, absolutely. There must have been so much positive energy flying around, and the best was yet to come.
And what about the press? Did they have anything to say?
Yes, absolutely. Motorcycle News covered it at the time, and had this to say. I'll read it out. Norton Motorcycles recorded their fastest ever lap around the Isle of Man mountain course this evening, as Dave Johnson put in his first flying lap on the V4-powered SG5. After a number of retirements so far this week, Johnson and the Norton team headed to Derby for a test earlier today, and speaking to MCN on the line for this evening's session, the Aussie was confident they'd fixed the issue. A rapid start to his opening lap saw Johnson clock the Norton's highest ever speed through the Sulby speed trap at 192.2 miles per hour before going on to record the iconic British Mark's fastest ever lap of the TT course with an average speed of 127.2 miles per hour. He followed that up with a 127.7 miles per hour on his first non-interrupted flying lap of the week to show a marked step forward for Norton, who have made huge progress with a new Magneti Marelli-based electronic system for 2016. But he didn't stop there. 128.32 miles per hour was the average speed recorded on his second standing start lap, and he looked set to improve once again on his second flyer until losing time in the final sector and crossing the line with an average speed of 127.3 miles per hour. Now we've got something to shout about, said Johnson after the session. To say they are our first full laps of the week, and they are all faster than Norton has ever been before, we are feeling pretty happy. The next step is to keep chipping away, and see where we can go. I'm pretty sure we can be hitting 130 miles per hour in race conditions.
Okay. Can you tell us all about your bike? Manxman number 6, which I believe was the last one to be made?
Yes, of course. I have owned Manxman number 6 from new. I had to have an informal interview with Charles Reynolds, the owner of Kickstart Motorcycles, at a Donington Park race meeting. He owns and runs a small race team and was there competing in the spring of 2017. He kindly gave us a couple of day passes, and we had a very enjoyable day watching the racing as well as chatting with Charles and meeting his team. We spoke mainly about the racing and how well they were doing. But that was enough for him to be happy selling the last Manxman to me. He later told me that he wouldn't have sold such a special bike to me if he didn't like me. Anyway, I took delivery of the bike on the 19th of January 2018, and it was stored in the dining room under its Norton dust cover until the 5th of April, when I took it for its first ride out. While I was waiting for the bike to be built, I found the perfect private registration plate, TT16 NOR. I have been asked many times if it was a show plate due to the TT2016 engraving on the bike, which reads, Manxman David Johnson, 130.86 miles per hour lap, IOM TT 2016. Which appears on the polished yoke along with Devo's signature. The same is on the oil filter cover, as well as his signature on the polished seat retaining nut. During my time of ownership, I have made a few subtle changes to further enhance the bike. Firstly, I had it decatted after its first service, which didn't produce any more power, but it did open up the exhaust, making it sound even better, especially on the overrun. All the early work on the bike was carried out at Donington Hall, as I happened to live close by. Later services were carried out by Stuart Bodicote, owner of Motivated Limited, and a good friend of mine. I also fitted a tail tidy to hold the number plate, as I didn't like the original low slung bracket that was fitted when the bike left the factory. I made and fitted a couple of aluminium Senior TT Racing number boards for the side of the bike, with number 15 in Norton font, as this was the number that Devo raced with on his Racing Norton in 2016. It is with a heavy heart that I have decided to give someone else an opportunity to own this beautiful bike. Therefore, it is up for sale. Anyway, if you would like to know more about my bike, then please get in touch via email. I will put it in the description below. If not, then I hope you have enjoyed watching this video about a little piece of previously unknown Isle of Man TT history, and the rare Norton Manxman that was inspired by that event.